It was my sophomore year of high school, and finally my coach decided to put me in the game. It was a late Friday night, and the crowd was going wild, cheering and stomping their feet. After weeks of practice and summer camp, I had finally earned my starting position on varsity football. I lined up, energized by the roar of the crowd, ready to prove myself on the field to show that I belonged. The crowd went silent as the balls kicked. I exploded off the line, charging towards the returner who caught the ball, eager to make a play. The field turned into a frenzy of blockers trying to protect their guy, and I dodged and fought through him, my eyes locked on a returner. I lowered my shoulders and hit him with everything I had, and he went down and fumbled the ball. I jumped on it and secured it for my team. Moments like these make all the hard work worth it, but not everything is always this easy. You see, I had a problem in the classroom. My teacher had just finished giving a lecture, and I was completely clueless about what was going on. Some people in my class understood, well, it sounded like she was speaking a completely foreign language to me. My grades were plummeting, and it even got down to an F at one point. My parents were livid, and I was worried about the consequences that would follow if I didn't fix this. Threats of having to lose my privileges or having to quit playing football were common. It was a dire situation, and I knew I needed to do something to fix this. I tried everything. I tried focusing more in class, asking more questions, and taking detailed notes. Everything that you think you would need to do better in a class. But at the end of the day, nothing worked. I'm still lost, and my grades were still low. It was all just so frustrating, all this effort for no return. And the impact of what this would do to my GPA was also beginning to set in. Hell, it would affect my chances of getting into the colleges that I wanted to or the scholarships that I needed. Around this time, I started hearing about AI tools such as ChatGPT. Many of my peers used it to write essays, and they had great success, so I decided to give it a try to see if it could help me with my problem. And through this, I realized that AI had far greater capabilities than just writing essays. I used it to recommend videos and explain things to me in a way that I would understand. I took pictures of problems and received step-by-step walkthroughs to find the solutions. I found that AI had a way of breaking down those complex topics in a way that I would be able to understand. Using AI, studying was made so much more easier. I was able to receive instant feedback on my homework or any other things I had questions on. It was a complete game changer. I was able to start understanding concepts more clearly, and this significantly increased my grades, eventually making me a straight A student. But not only was it effective in my academic life, but it also tremendously helped me learn concepts and skills at an accelerated rate. And this is all because AI adapts to each student's needs. It provides tailored support, sort of like a 24/7 tutor that specifically works for you. This allows it to explain things in various ways as many times as you need until they make sense. And research shows that this personalized form of education leads to enhanced academic performance. A study by the University of Stanford titled Smart Tutoring Through Conversational Interfaces even found that AI-powered tutoring systems effectively adapted to students' needs, leading to better learning outcomes across grade levels and subjects. So if you want to integrate these same benefits into your education, you can start today with ChatGPT, a general AI model that is very versatile. Next time you're stuck or want to learn a new concept or skill, pull out your device and tell ChatGPT your problem, the solution you want to reach, and how you want to receive that information. Prompting ChatGPT is a skill that you must master if you want to receive the most specific and personalized solutions. For example, say you were struggling with integration techniques in calculus. You could prompt the AI by asking it to explain the methods of integration by parts and to provide an example and further go into detail on each step taken to solve that problem. Or if you wanted to learn the electric guitar, you can prompt the AI by asking it to provide you a step-by-step guide for learning the electric guitar as a beginner and provide resources and videos for each step. Just keep in mind that AI is a tool to enhance your learning, not a crutch to avoid doing work. This means instead of prompting ChatGPT to write you an essay, you give it your pre-written essay and ask it to critique and grade it so you can go back in and make improvements. By applying these tips, you can also take advantage of the powerful tool that AI is. Because when students integrate AI models such as ChatGPT into their education, they are able to personalize general learning to help them succeed. So I encourage you to go tackle that homework you've been struggling on, or go pursue that hobby that has always seemed daunting. Grab any AI tool of your choice and start your prompt with, how can I, or can you explain? AI is not just a tool of the future. It is here now, ready to help us learn better and faster. So let us all embrace AI in our educational journeys and unlock our full potentials.